Hi everybody, welcome to my weekly Yana Talks About Stuff. Today I want to talk about hair color and specifically coloring your hair at home. This is what I did yesterday and this is the result that I got. I naturally have medium brown hair, but yesterday I woke up and I kid you not, I was like, I have to color my hair today. I don't care when, I don't care what I do, I just have to do something with my hair. Which is kind of strange because I really don't do anything to my hair ever. I don't really color it much. I had a bunch of, you know, highlights in high school, but I really didn't do much since. But yesterday was the day when I decided to change my hair color and I decided to do it at home by myself. And this is what I got. And I'm actually pretty happy with it. But that being said, this is why I'm here. I wanted to schmake this video. Oh, it's so hot in here. So there's some tips and tricks that I learned while I was doing my hair that I wish I knew ahead of time that I want to share with you guys. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started on those tips and tricks. So tip number one is always do a virtual makeover test before you do any drastic changes to your appearance. I did mine in Photoshop, but you can also go on this website called taaz.com that allows you to upload your photo on their website and then you can add makeup and hairstyles to your photo and then see what you look like with different styles. And that way you'll be able to see if it's something that you even look good in. Now, another thing you can do is ask people what they think, especially after you do this virtual makeover test. You'll have this photo of yourself before and after, and then you can say, hey, you know, I'm thinking about changing my hair color, what do you think? Ask your friends, ask your boyfriend if you have one, family members, and see what they say. That's what I did. I asked my boyfriend, a couple friends, and they all said, well, they said, some said you should go lighter, some said you should go darker, but I didn't get the, you know, overwhelming, do not do it, this is a big mistake, do not do it. So, you know, I went for it and I'm really happy with it. I do also want to say that you don't have to take people's opinions, you know, as the be all and end all. You don't have to listen to people at all. You should always listen to your own voice. But if you want to get second opinion, I think that's smart because, you know, if there's some sort of a really big mistake that you're doing, you might be able to catch it before you do anything. Okay, so when you're picking hair color, now, you might already have a hair color picked out. If you don't, listen to this really quickly. I'll go over this super quick because I'm not an expert in this, but I did some research when I was picking my own hair color. And here are some tips from experts, not me because I'm not an expert, but from experts and stylists and celebrity stylists and blah, blah, blah. Number one, if you're deciding whether you want to go darker or lighter, typically speaking, and there are exceptions, but typically speaking, darker hair looks good on people that have darker skin tone and darker eyes. Lighter skin or lighter hair colors look better on people that have lighter skin tones and lighter eye colors. So if you have really dark skin tone, dark eyes, you're gonna look really good with dark hair. And then vice versa, again, there are exceptions, so you might be the exception, but if you're starting somewhere, start here. Fourth tip, however, whatever number tip this is, when you're picking your hair color tone, which is whether you want it to be warm color or cool color, neutral color, you always want to check your skin tone. Your skin tone is either going to be warm or cool. I have a warm skin tone, but some people have cool skin tones, obviously. And the way you can tell that is, well, there are many tests, but one test is looking at your veins and seeing if your veins are green or they're purplish blue. If your veins are green, that means you have a warmer skin tone. If your veins are purplish blue, that means you have a cool skin tone. And so if you have a cool skin tone, you want to go for more neutral hair colors, more cooler hair colors. And vice versa, if you have a warmer skin tone like me, you want to go for warmer hair colors. So the one thing you do want to think of before you do anything with your hair color is your brows. Because if your brows will not be able to match your new hair color, you're going to look so unnatural and fake. Which brings me to my next point, which is, if you are going to change your hair color at home, I suggest you do it incrementally or don't have a drastic change. So if you have a medium brown hair like I did, go either a little bit lighter or a little bit darker, but don't go either jet black or a platinum blonde. At least, you know, after one time. There's so much that can go wrong when you're trying to completely change your hair color like that. I would suggest, better yet, just try to change it a little bit. Go a shade lighter or a shade darker, and you know, that way you really can't mess up too much. And if you don't like it, it's not that much different, so it's really not that bad. It's not that big of a deal. Alright, so as far as the kind of product that I use this product right here, which is Clairol. I had to go online and watch a video of somebody pronouncing this to make sure I'm not mispronouncing it, which I'm probably still mispronouncing it. Clairol. But this was the brand that was recommended the most when I did my quick online search. Everybody, most people recommended this specific brand for your hair color needs at home, hair color needs. So the color that I chose for my hair was 4 dark brown, former 28, and it looks like this. This is what I got, and I did have a medium brown hair, because I'm sure if you had a different kind of hair you would not exactly get the same result. But yeah, this was under 10 bucks and it worked perfectly. This is a semi-permanent color, which is something I absolutely recommend you doing as well. If you're coloring your hair at home, unless you're a pro, do not buy permanent hair color, because if you mess up or you don't like the shade or you don't want to upkeep your hair color, you're going to be screwed basically, because you now have this permanent hair color that's pretty much stuck with you forever unless you, you know, continuously upkeep it. It says that it will last for 28 shampoos, so obviously depending on how often you wash your hair and what kind of shampoo you have and stuff, you know, it probably will last for a month or two or something like that, which isn't horrible, because even if you mess up, even if you hate your hair color and there's nothing you can do, you just have to wait for it to fade, it can fade with in as little as a month or even 3 weeks if you're really washing your hair all the time. So it's really not that big of a deal. If you do it permanently, however, you can really do some damage. All in all, it probably took 15 minutes for me to color my hair, which was super quick. It says 10 minutes, you should leave it on for 10 minutes, but you know, the application and stuff that took another 5. So 15 minutes for your hair color, super quick, super easy. And another good thing about this specific brand is that it's ammonia free. Ammonia is a thing that allows the hair color to stick better to your hair, but unfortunately while it's doing that, it's also compromising your hair structure and making it weak and brittle and basically damages your hair. So because this is ammonia free, it's better for your hair and it's more gentle, so that's always a great thing. So this is a used one. This is exactly what I used yesterday on myself, so it's already opened and used. So the one you would get, a new one, wouldn't look like this exactly, but it would have the same stuff in it. So it comes with a little instruction right here, and it comes with 2 bottles. Again, it wouldn't look like that when you get a new one, but because it's already used, this is what it looks like after you use it. You basically open this up and open this bottle up, and then you dump the contents of this bottle into this bottle. You shake it, you take off the little cap, and then you start distributing the color into your hair, and you also get gloves. And then after you're done with that, you rinse the color off and you put the conditioner on. And they give you a lot of conditioner here, so you can keep using it every time you wash it for however long it lasts. So a couple things on coloring your hair. Number one is you wanna wear a long sleeve shirt or a trash bag on yourself, because I did accidentally get some color on my skin, on my arms. It did come off pretty easy, but if you want to be extra careful, just wear a long sleeve shirt that you don't mind ruining, basically, or a trash bag. But you do want to be careful with your arms, you don't get any color on your arms like I did. Do not forget to set the timer ahead of time for roughly 15 minutes. So that way it gives you 5 minutes to apply the color and then 10 minutes to leave it in. If you do it afterwards, it might be difficult to make sure that your hands are clean and you're not touching your phone or timer, like an actual timer, prehistoric timer, with sticky color hands. You want to put a napkin or a piece of plastic or a plastic bag underneath the color bottle that you're using in case it leaks. It leaked a little bit for me, and left a stain on the counter, and I was freaking out. I thought the counter was ruined. I was able to get it out, but I don't want you to have to deal with a little panic attack like I did. So just to be on the safe side, do put like a little piece of paper or cardboard or something to prevent the staining from happening in case there's gonna be some staining. If you're using this hair color, Clairol, or if you're using this brand, they ask you to wet your hair. Make sure you wet it thoroughly. I didn't do a good job of wetting my hair, and I did notice that the color was going on not as smooth on the parts that weren't as wet as it was on the parts that were wet. If you make sure that your hair is properly wetted, you're gonna have a much better time of applying the color in, especially if you're using this brand. Do not apply too much color around your hairline. If you get a little bit of color on your forehead, make sure you wipe it as soon as you can. And again, I really wouldn't put too much color here. You do want to put some color because you don't want it to look to be a different color than the rest of your hair. But you don't want it to be so dark because it's unnatural. People usually have some lighter areas around their face just to kind of frame it. So don't put really, really dark hair right here. Don't put a lot of color here. Do not forget about applying the hair color on the sides and on the bottom of your hair in case you want to wear a ponytail or something like that. I almost forgot about the bottom of my hair, which is kind of sad. I didn't forget it at the end, but I almost forgot, and I want to make sure that you don't forget it. So just flip it. Well, here's how I did it. I started from the top and I kind of worked my way down, and I flipped my hair and I started to work from the bottom out, and then I made sure that the tips, my hair ends, got enough hair color on them. So that was kind of my technique. You don't have to obviously follow my technique, but that's something that worked for me. I do also want to say that if you have long hair, do not flip your hair fast, because what's going to happen is the color on your hair is going to splatter everywhere. Guess who that happened to? Me. So back to the brows. I mentioned brows in the beginning of this video. You do want to make sure that you color your brows if you feel like your brows are a little too light or a little too dark. If you have really boxy inner brows, I feel like that makes them look so unnatural, and you want to avoid that, I hope. And so the way to do it is to start from the middle of the eye and work your way out. And that's what I did, and I was really happy with the result. So if you take a Q-tip and apply it to the middle of the eye and work your way out on the brow, that's gonna give you a really nice amount of color on them without making them seem unnatural. Another tip on coloring your brows is don't try to make your brow seem thicker by coloring slightly outside of the lines. That's gonna make it seem unnatural as well. So two things: you wanna stay inside the lines, and you want to color from the middle point of the brow out. All right, and then the last tip as far as the application of the color is concerned, make sure you wash thoroughly, and do not be freaked out when you see all this color coming down the drain, because all that color depends on how much you apply and how long your hair is. But for me, it literally took me 5 minutes for me to wash out all that color, and it kept going, going, going. It's gonna take a while for it to all wash off. And make sure you don't forget to wash the bottom of your hair, because that's one part it's not that I forgot to wash it, but I guess I didn't wash it thoroughly enough. And there was some color left when I turned off the shower, and I was like, what is this like greasy part of my hair? And then I saw it was color, and I was like, oops, I gotta rewash that. And now the aftermath of coloring your hair, you are probably going to, depends on what you do with your hair, if you go lighter or darker, you are probably going to want to explore new makeup looks. You might want to adjust your wardrobe a little bit. You might need to get new like hair ties and bobby pins. It is something you want to look at. I did notice that darker hair does allow for heavier makeup, so I can do my eyes darker, my lips darker, without me seeming like a drag queen. I was really worried I would look like a drag queen before I started to color my hair. I was really nervous about it, and again, I've never colored my hair before, so I had no clue what it was going to come out to look like, but I'm really happy with the results. Thank you so much for watching. To any of you who are still sticking around, I hope you have a wonderful time coloring your hair and everything turns out just perfect and there are no oops moments. I'm gonna link my blog and some of the social media profiles down below if you guys wanna check those out or friend me on any of them. And with that, again, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye.